Good day from Chem Help ASAP. If you're watching these videos as a playlist, we've already outlined the challenge of designing a new drug. We need good drug potency for our target, that's pharmacodynamics, along with a good half-life for once per day dosing, that's pharmacokinetics. Where do we start in our search for a drug? We need a lead, a molecule with promising target binding and pharmacokinetics that we can refine to meet the FDA's safe and effective standards. This stage is called lead discovery. The lead discovery process normally starts with a collection of molecules called a library. Drug companies employ many organic chemists who make drug-like molecules as part of their job. A sample of every new molecule is placed in the company's compound library. A compound library for a large drug company can have a million or even several million molecules. Remember that as part of a new drug program, molecular biologists will identify a drug target and develop a binding assay to measure interactions between a molecule and target protein. This assay will be used to test the binding for a large fraction of the company's extensive molecule library in an automated process called high-throughput screening, or HTS. Most compounds will have negligible potency, but a small fraction, maybe 1%, will show promise. So we go from over a million down to maybe 10,000. These promising compounds are called hits and will be further scrutinized, not just for potency, but also their potential pharmacokinetic properties. There are actually high-throughput screens that can predict a drug's ADME properties. The very best molecules will be tested in animals for additional early information on both potency and pharmacokinetics. The end result of all this testing will be a small number, likely five or fewer, lead molecules with decent potency, pharmacokinetic properties, and safety profiles that warrant continued intensive investigation.